started with our first caller who's already called in. He's joining us from Mumbai. Sumit Agarwal has called us. Sumit, go ahead, tell us what's your question. How can we help you?
Yeah, hi, good evening. Yeah, see, yes, I have purchased a property in one of the locations in Virar.
Yes, Sumit, go on.
So, right now, I'm facing, delayed possession. So
Sumit, if your TV is switched on, if you've turned on your TV, you'll need to mute the volume. That is why we're getting that disturbance. Can you do that for me?
Yeah, I'm out at the moment. I'm not at my place.
Okay, so okay. Go on then. Go on.
Yeah, so this is a property taken in the year 2013. This was an under-construction property. And as per the agreement, the possession was supposed to be given in the year 2014, December.
Okay.
But have yet not got the possession.
Yes, Sumit.
Yeah, so now, it is clearly mentioned in the agreement that the possession has to be given in December 2014.
Mm-hmm.
And if the builder fails to give the possession, then, he has to, buyer can initiate the buyback of the flat with the builder.
Okay.
And builder has to pay 9% simple interest.
If you negotiate a buyback, then the builder has to pay 9% simple interest. Is that what is...
It's been mentioned in the agreement.
Okay.
Now I'm discussing with the builder, for a buyback, but he is refusing. He's saying that I cannot honor this agreement right now, which is being, given by the builder itself.
Right, Sumit. Would you want to name the builder?
It is in a project called Global City in Virar.
Delayed possession. According to the contract, he can negotiate with the builder for a buyback and also get 9% simple interest. Now, Anshuman, what should he do?
See, as he has proposed a buyback under his own agreement, essentially what will happen is it would be another sale transaction in favor of the builder again. Of course, that will attract independently stamp duties and everything, and the document will have to be registered. Nevertheless, the fact that he's agreed in your contract, he has to honor it. And definitely you would be entitled to have it sold back to him. But this is actually a very odd sort of a contract, and it is not ordinarily upheld, because what happens is what MOFA provides for is in case of a delay, there can be an interest payable or else there could be a cancellation. So ideally he should have provided for cancellation. Nevertheless, now that he has provided for a buyback, he could get it specifically enforced from the civil court and ensure that he buys back at a particular rate. But the question is, of course, whether the rate has been mentioned, at what price. If it was for the same old price, then probably you can enforce it with additional interest from that date till date of actual realization.
Sumit, what exactly is mentioned in the agreement? Is the price mentioned?
Ma'am, sorry for the interruption. See, actually, I will just take my word back. So it is not buyback. It is mentioned in the agreement that I can cancel if builder fails to pay on the date agreed, then buyer has the right to
refund. So that is exactly the provision under MOFA. Actually, buyback would be a very different nature of a contract altogether. So what you have provided, what I've mentioned, is actually what is provided under the Act as well. So therefore, this is a general right that is available to you, and you can get it specifically enforced through the court.
But
if you are no more interested in the flat,
so you essentially are saying that he needs to go to court.
Yes, he will essentially need to go to the court because it appears that the builder is no more cooperating with him.
So send a legal notice first, establish a paper trail, and then go to court.
Of course, because you will have to exercise your right for a cancellation and refund of the amount. But you have to be clear that the day you cancel it, then your right to claim specific performance of the flat back will automatically stand extinguished. So you will have to take a very decisive call on this.
Okay, and what does that mean?
So basically it would mean that the day he says that I don't want a flat and you please give me back my money, then his right to claim the flat again will not be available to him. So the decision has to be concrete in his part. He has to really think about it. And if he really feels that he doesn't need the flat anymore, then only he should exercise his option.
Right. So once, Sumit, you've decided not to take that flat from the developer and instead take the compensation that the developer stands to give you only, then you should send him a legal notice and ask him to give you, refund the money with 9% simple interest like he has laid out in the agreement. If he doesn't do so, then you can go to court. Okay? You know, before we move on, very quickly, like you said, under MOFA, there is nothing like a buyback. But we have heard of developers of late who are, you know, coming up with buyback assurance schemes. Okay. Now, how safe are these buyback assurance schemes? And if one does enter into something like that with the the developer, how can it be enforced? Because you're saying it's not there under
MOFA. Correct. So what happens is these are alternate investment schemes is what generally the courts have been observing. SEBI and Competition Commission both have actually observed on such issues that these are not pure transaction of sale and purchase of real estate, and they are in the nature of investment schemes. And therefore, for such schemes to be floated, there needs to be proper approval that has to be sought by the developer. So such schemes are definitely avoidable. And even if, as a worst scenario, the specific performance of such schemes may not be available, and it may unnecessarily result in complications. So buybacks are something which, as a plain purchaser, should not be encouraged, and it is avoidable to enter into such kind of transactions.
Right. So key takeaway coming for you there: ideally avoid a buyback assurance scheme. It does look very attractive. It does sound very attractive, considering the delays that are rampant in the property market currently. However, do remember that the buyback assurance scheme is just another name for a collective investment scheme which needs to be regulated by SEBI and other regulators. So if it is not approved by SEBI, you're probably better off not buying into that buyback assurance scheme.